What is happiness? You might know from my recent videos that I feel like I'm going through a quarter-life crisis, where all my definitions of happiness and success and what I want out of life are shape-shifting. It's really a time of closure from the past and getting ready to launch into new beginnings for me. Taking what I'm learning from Erin Dowdy and the book Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself and actually putting it into action. I've now defined and outlined the old identity, the old personality that I don't prefer to continue, and the new personality, or the true personality that I do want to continue. The definition of happiness that I've come up with lately is to just love being yourself so much that you do not rather want to be anyone else, look like anyone else, have anyone else's life, have anyone else's personality, etc. I really do feel like that is the definition of happiness right now. By the way, the new Seether album is fucking amazing. I very recently put the final moves on cutting ties completely with a handful of toxic family members. After that confrontation, I realized how much they were stuck in the same mindset they were years ago and how much mine has changed during that time period. But I know if I keep my body so used to feeling resentful and my emotions so used to being victimized and not trusting people, I'm always going to be stuck in that old identity, even if all of my habits like meditation and yoga are really good. I started a new relationship this April, and my thoughts, emotions, and nervous system have been going through such a roller coaster, just getting used to what it's actually like to be in a healthy relationship with someone who treats me with respect. Because my last relationship that I left in 2017 was very controlling and abusive. Over the last 3 years, I found meditation, started my spiritual awakening, and I've done all of my shadow work. Well, there's always going to be more shadow work, but I've done a good chunk of it. And I'm just so ready to keep doing things I've never done and keep trying things that I never thought I would do. Doing things that the new identity does that the old identity never would have, like rock climbing.
Supposed to be aimed at you. Country road.
Take me home to the place I belong.
Mountain mama, take me home. Mountain road.
Now that I've tried to talk to you and make you understand,
I helped.
It's not all the good I do is close your eyes and just reach out for me and touch me. Hold me close, don't.
You got the wrong hand on top. Left hand, there you go.
I know this.
Much.
It's like you're not.
This much is true. I know.
Why don't you like metal?
What?
Why don't you like metal music?
Because it's not like this. It just doesn't bleed like this music.
It doesn't bleed? Oh, come on. It totally bleeds. It bleeds hard. When you've been through trauma and or you have mental health struggles like me, a lot of the struggle with being happy is literally just letting yourself be happy. My old programming and thoughts are constantly trying to just be like, whoa, happiness? We don't recognize this. And then my ego wants to get me back to that familiar state.
It's a pretty.
This one.
Oh, they're already gone.
Gotcha. Yeah. There's a Aww. Really tall one here.
The best time of year, Keegan.
Wait, it's a holiday?
It's time for pumpkin spice.
Is
like
it actually
your
a holiday?
Hair color. Oh, vegans are never gonna change anything. Like, you can try, but like, you're never gonna change anything. Vegan frozen pizza.
Look,
wow, look at that. Plant-based meal. It's meatless protein.
This is all
plant-based cheese and spread. This whole thing? Wow. Vegans are never gonna change anything. It's so hard to be vegan. What do I even eat?
I have no idea.
Wow, no evil. That is a good brand to, or name to call your brand. It's actually true. If you have anybody toxic in your life, whether they are friends or even blood relatives, such as people who are abusive, who have perhaps personality disorders or extreme narcissism, not only is it okay to completely cut contact with them and cut them out of your life in extreme cases, but you have to. It's like you can't have a spiritual awakening or grow into who you want to be unless you do that first. That doesn't mean it's easy. That doesn't mean it won't hurt you, especially if they're blood relatives. But you need to have high enough self-esteem to not allow anybody in your life to talk down to you or disrespect you at all. And there's no exceptions to that. The fish in the sea don't wanna die for your sushi. Begin to order, begin.
No one had to die for this burger.
Not to mention that it's just fucking weird.
Yeah.
Why are we breeding an animal into existence, putting them on a farm, putting them through hell, stealing their babies, literally having bestiality with them, putting your hand in their anus, artificially inseminating, and then taking their milk?
And killing
That's
them
fucking
when
weird.
They're spent.
Why not just take soybeans, which are like pretty much one of the easiest plants to grow, insane amount of protein, probably the exact same amount, if not maybe 1 gram less, per 8 ounce cup. I know milk has like 8. I guarantee soy is like 7. I know at the store you can buy it at 7. But why not just blend it and make your own fucking milk and then leave the fucking cow alone?
Slowly roll and pivot so you're on to that left heel, bending into the right knee. We'll switch sides, no rushing, feel every motion.
Okay, take the hand place each way.
thought vegans were weak.
Nope. Protein comes from plants. Do you know where animals get their protein?
I know. Where do they get theirs?
From plants. Maybe not these plants.
No.
These plants don't have too much protein. They're more flowers, you know.
Incredible really have, knowledge you know, being shared here.
This is a typical Elysia moment where we spend more time at the parking lot than the actual trail.
I'm home. Keegan just dropped me off a second ago, and I've got a fuck ton of cleaning to do. The next time I see Keegan in about 2 weeks, we're actually going with my mom to Florida to visit my grandma. We're driving there, and it's gonna be fun. And then, not too long after that, we're gonna start our cross-country road trip, which is going to go definitely more than a month, but I'm not sure how long. And so I'm really excited to start that process. So there's going to be a video coming up very soon of like the planning process, like the episode one of the journey, if you will. So that'll be fucking exciting.
When I heard that Earthling Ed talk, and he was just basically talking about literally chopping up somebody's body parts and eating them, I just thought to myself, oh my God, what am I doing? Like, this is so barbaric. I can't do this anymore.
Okay, so it's a very busy day here at the park, and we're gonna force our views onto these innocent people.
Terrible, terrible, kind, pity-free lifestyle.
Early we get up to get ready and head out to visit the slaughterhouse in Newark, New Jersey. Our victims are already here, and we're gonna give them these big things of water that we came here with. Bear witness, give them some kindness. The only kindness they've ever received in their life, most likely. So scared. A lot of them are too scared to even accept the water. Look how depressed they look. They hang their heads low. Now as we're heading back, the truck is already pulled in so the animals can be unloaded to their unjust and unnecessary murder. The theme of this vlog is about defining and finding happiness. But why would we think that we have the right to find happiness by taking it away from others? Tell me if you see any happiness in these next clips.
It's not being a very smart person to see that. These are signs of distress. If this was a dog, you would not question if the dog was happy, or how do you know the dog's not happy?
No.